This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. I'm Jay, that's Casey.
Hello everyone.
Alright, what are we drinking today?
Today, I walked into the store yesterday, and I saw a beer with a pentagram on it, so why not? It is Star Hill Sabbath, and it is a Black Indian Pale Ale, and it says, the gift of great beer.
Which is our...
I'll hold it up to the camera so you guys can see it. Yeah, it's a pretty interesting label there. That's the whole reason I bought it, just to see what it's like. It's 7%, 7.2, I think it says. And we looked at it a little bit. I guess it's only made seasonal.
Yeah, so, right around Halloween.
Yeah. Oh, you got to use it again. Yeah, we didn't have to wait till next year.
I thought it was going to take a whole year to use it again. But.
Yeah. I hope Satan doesn't possess us when we drink this. It is really dark, though. I can hold that up to the camera. It almost looks like a porter or a stout. It is very, very black, like my soul. Let's go ahead and try it.
Shall we?
Ooh.
That is very strong.
Yeah, that is... Doesn't that taste like a stout or a porter or something?
With a shitload more hop.
Yeah.
I mean, it's got that chocolate roastiness going on.
Like, ooh, now I'm getting porter. That came in later.
Yeah, but you get like that floral citrusy thing going on.
Yeah, did you get a fruit thing at the beginning?
Yeah, yeah. It's the hops, man. They got a lot of hop in there that's giving it that whole floral citrus
thing. Two very different tastes for me. Once you first taste it, you get like a citrus, fruit, something like that. And then at the end, you get this very, it like sneaks up on you like Satan.
It tastes great together.
You get this chocolatey, like, sort of like the porter last time. Porter!
Porter!
Oh, but that's very good. It looked like a little crazy, and I didn't know if it was going to be good or not, but I don't know. What do you think about that? Do you think that's good at all, or?
I'm going a good solid 4 out of 5. What are we rating in today?
We're going to go... I'm going to do 4, too. I think it's really good. We're going to go... I just seen one of these last night for the first time outside of California. So we're going to do 4 out of 5 man buns.
Man buns.
Yes, I saw a guy with a man bun.
Hey, don't knock the mun.
Out in the middle of nowhere where we live, believe it or not. I can't believe I saw one, but... Yeah, that's a very interesting taste.
I like it.
Yes, I do too. I think it's delicious. Four out of five man buns.
Four out of five man buns.
Yes. We'll give it that because I really like it. Hopefully Satan, like I said, doesn't, you know, demonize our butthole after drinking it, but whatever.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, that was delicious.
Well, we're going to get into some news stories and some other goofy things today, but today's a special show. So make sure you watch to the end. Telling you now, we're going to have a game to play. We're going to have, Casey's got something interesting going on. What do you have today?
For the first thing, what we're going to do is we're going to watch a woman swallow a whole stick of butter.
Yeah. What?
Yeah, dude.
Does she just unhinge her jaw like a snake?
No, I don't know. Well, women are succubus, so I'm joking. Serpents. But yeah, we're just gonna watch this real quick, and then we'll talk about it. This is just really amazing to me. I don't know how you talk about this or why you want to do this, but we are gonna check this out. Go ahead and let's watch this real quick.
I
think
gagging.
Find your zen place.
Yeah, that's what he
Hold
said.
Your hair if you gag.
She's standing here in the kitchen. There's people all around her and everything. And she's about to swallow a whole stick of butter.
Ready? I'll take the rest.
I'm afraid of what?
You totally got it.
My God.
Oh, she's even like pushing her fingers down her throat.
What I'm not getting though is why she doesn't have a wedding ring on her finger.
I know. Did you like the end? Did you see it drip out there at the end there? For people not watching us on YouTube, oh, I like the next one, sausage contest. But
I want to cancel that.
Yeah. At the end there, after she's done, she opens up her mouth to show that she swallowed the whole stick of butter, and this little drip comes out. So we know, you know, the answer if she spits or swallows or not. But how does this come up in conversation?
Like, I don't know, but you know what? If you happen to see our show, Lady with the Stick of Butter, contact us. We will put you on the show.
Yeah, because I don't see a wedding ring either. And, you know, there's probably some guy there that is married, and he's just like, God, I put the wrong ring on the finger, on the wrong finger, man. Jesus. But, like...
See, Casey, you do have hope.
Yeah, I know. Jesus, I'm in love, man. Oh, getting a little warm in here. But why butter? Like... It's a square yellow stick of butter.
Just
like, did she have a dream about sucking SpongeBob's dick or something? And she was like, yo, I'm going to try this out. Or was she just drunk one night and she's like, yo, Tina, I got an idea. I'm going to swallow a whole stick of butter. Why butter?
It's kind of like hold my beer, except for hold my Merlot.
Yeah. And I don't know. How many times has she done this? Like, do you think you can die from this?
I don't know, but she has no gag reflex.
I know.
None.
She and I love the part where she like makes sure it's down there, like good girl. Like she's like,
don't waste it.
Yep. And that was actually a video that our friend Sue, thank you Sue, don't worry, I won't say your last name. Sue showed to me, and I was like, dude, I gotta cover this on the show. And I was like, don't worry, we won't use your last name, so you're safe, Sue. That, you know, you're not gonna be. People are gonna know that you know us. We'll
and if they find out, she'll just kick your ass.
Yeah, I know, she probably would. But thank you, Sue. She's our dear friend, and she posted that video. So
our,
I thought that
our
was
our dear friend.
Yes, our dear friend.
You say that with the Potter?
Yeah, Potter.
All right.
I know. I just don't know what to think after that. Like, I'm sort of turned on. I sort of, you know, want to go to a buffet.
I'm kind of slightly nauseous.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what else to do about that.
I don't know.
Getting warm.
Might want to turn the Casey cam back on.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
We're still experimenting with this whole three camera setup. Yeah. So I hope you guys like it, because it is a shitload of work for us.
Yeah, I know. It seems to be work. Oh, that reminds me. I got to take this lid off this so I don't burn my fucking mouth again.
Oh, yeah. Your freaking nuclear cup. I got to get me one of them travel mugs.
Oh, it's worth it, man.
My little Ocean City mug. It was still cold when I got it yesterday.
Yeah. Like I was telling Jay earlier, I washed that last week after the show. And about 2 hours later, I came to put it back when it was dry. And it was still, like, pretty hot from the hot water I was using to wash it. Oh, it's like the Nazis made it or something.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, it is. Oh, man. So, all right. Moving on after watching a girl swallow a whole stick of butter.
Oh, what should I start with? I think I'm going to go with Colin Kaepernick's a bitch.
Oh, really? What do he do now? Is he, like,
you know,
not standing while he's peeing?
Yeah. Well, he didn't fucking vote. And Stephen A., the ESPN anchor, just he just fucking rips him a new asshole. In fact, I'm gonna show a little video clip here quickly, and an audio clip of just Stephen A. just destroying Colin Kaepernick, and it pretty well sums it up. So let's take a peek at that. Someday I will have that up.
Stephen A., did he betray his cause?
He absolutely betrayed his cause. As far as I'm concerned, Colin Kaepernick is absolutely irrelevant. I don't want to see him again. I don't want to hear from him again. I don't want to hear a damn word about anything that he has to say about our nation, the issues that we have, racial injustices, needing change, et cetera, et cetera. He comes across as a flaming hypocrite. As far as I'm concerned, I'm not interested in a damn word that he has to say. And quite frankly, I hope he goes away. He's lucky to be in the league right now. And Colin Kaepernick, after all this noise that you made, even though you didn't intend to do so by a defending our military servicemen and women and pointing out about how you wanted to bring attention to racial injustices and beyond this in this country, to turn around and not to even take your behind to the polls to vote for a particular candidate, it is shameful. Absolutely shameful. Him of all people because of the position he took, because of the attention he brought to the issues. The fact that you don't even have the decency to go to the polls and activate yourself in this election, as our president said, is a damn shame. I don't want to hear another word from Colin Kaepernick. It's a waste of time. A matter of fact, I would personally make a request to the media in this nation. Wherever he is, if he ain't on that football field trying to throw another damn incomplete pass, do me a favor and make sure of one thing. Take the camera away from him. It means nothing. Because for him not to vote, as far as I'm concerned, everything he said meant absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. I don't want to hear another damn word from him. Nothing.
I agree wholeheartedly.
Oh, my God. He should be a preacher.
Stephen A., he's just pissed.
Oh, my God,
I mean,
dude.
He should be pissed.
He just had that accent, like, don't you ever.
here's the deal. I didn't agree with the whole fucking thing to begin with, because I've been saying from the get-go that Colin Kaepernick, he's taking an issue that, regardless whether or not you believe it's a real issue or whatever, he believes strongly in it. Mm-hmm. Enough that he was going to make a stand. Well, a sit.
Yeah. Could have worded that better.
He was gonna
I won't stand for it.
He was gonna make a fucking stink about it. And of course people are gonna start asking questions, and he's gonna end up being a face of a movement. And the whole fucking thing is, you take an issue that you feel strongly about and you're making it about yourself.
I know, exactly.
And that's the whole problem with the whole thing.
And that's what I was getting to when we talked about, like, people just, you know, doing nice things because you get likes on Facebook for it. And it's, it seems like this is what it is.
Did you hear about the guy who started fires so he could get Facebook likes?
Oh, my God. See, and that's what I'm just saying. It's like, oh, my God, man. Everyone just wants to fucking just feel like a good person.
Well, and this whole Colin Kaepernick thing, you know, if you're going to fucking do these things and draw attention to yourself and piss off your service people, haul your ass in a fucking pole, just like Stephen A. said. And you know what? If you don't, you're a bitch. I don't give a fuck what you have to say. I didn't really care to begin with. But now it's like, how can you expect people to take you fucking seriously? When you're talking about change, you take the avenue to make that change and you ignore it.
I know, and I love it, dude. He should be a pastor at a church, man. He fucking goes nuts, and I love it.
And here's the thing. Colin Kaepernick said, this is a quote here. "You know, I think it would be hypocritical of me to vote. I said from the beginning I was against oppression. I was against the system of oppression. I'm not going to show support for that system. And to me, the oppressor isn't going to allow you to vote your way out of your oppression."
That's not the point.
What the fuck?
That's not the point. The point is if just
so Colin Kaepernick, you
so
take
stupid. Like who's your PR guy? Fire him. What a fucking dumbass. Didn't he text you and be like, "Dude, get your ass to vote, man. You caused a lot of fucking trouble."
That's exactly the whole point of voting. You go out there and you make your voice heard.
It's the principle of the thing. And I don't even believe in voting, and I think you should have voted if you were in this thing.
Well, yeah, if you're going to go out there and fucking say all this shit, talk all this crap, piss off all these people, the least you can do, the absolute least you can do is go out and try to make a difference.
I know, because, you know, when this happened, how many vets were probably sitting there missing fucking arms, have shrapnel in them from fucking bombs and stuff, sitting there watching this fucking clown do this shit, and then you don't even fucking vote?
I mean, you know, you don't even have the decency to go out and back up the cause. You know, that whole thing, it would be hypocritical of me to vote. You know what that says? I was too lazy to get up early on a fucking Tuesday.
Yeah, he's like, I have an afro appointment later. You know, I got to be awake for that because, you know, I'm probably looking in the mirror because I'm obsessed with myself. But, you know, whatever.
The fact of the matter is, Colin Kaepernick is a bitch.
Yep, it's a joke. It's a joke from when they said... It's a joke from when they found out, you know, he was wearing fucking socks with pigs and cop uniforms on his socks. Yeah, it's all about the cause. No, you're just a fucking asshole.
Yep.
And that's the thing. You could do whatever you want in this country, but we're going to make the fucking fun of you.
And Roger Goodell wonders why the ratings are slipping. Gee, I don't know.
Yeah, I couldn't tell you fucking why.
It's just gotten to the point where anymore, there's so many fucking penalty flags being thrown. You know?
I know.
This isn't going to be a popular opinion, but you know what? Player safety, fuck you.
I know. And that's the thing
you,
here.
You get paid millions of dollars to play a child's game for a living. Shut the fuck up.
And that's like me. Like, I want blood.
You know what? I think we ought to just get rid of all the anti-doping shit and just let them all be a bunch of roided up Supermen.
I know.
It'll be entertaining as fuck.
It would be like NASCAR. You know how much money you got to make the best car? How much money you got to make the best drug?
Fucking... Go ahead and you remember that Sega video game, Monster League Football?
Oh, man.
We need to get that shit for real.
Oh, I love that. And they had Mutant League Hockey. And actually, since the success of that Nintendo thing that came out, they sold out. People are fucking pissed.
Well, they made like 10 of them, I think.
Yeah, and now, since the success of that, Sega is thinking about releasing one.
They already have one.
Oh, are you serious?
You can go right now to Toys R Us and buy a little miniature Sega console with a bunch of games built in.
Oh yeah, we do at the mall.
At the mall, yeah.
God,
yeah, you can go. I was looking.
I always feel like a pedophile. They're like, "What is this old creepy? What is this old creepy white guy doing in Toys R Us?" No, I'm just looking for the new Sega thing. Please, please don't call the cops on me. Oh man, yes.
Yeah, Colin Kaepernick's a bitch.
Yeah, what a bitch. That's fun to say. What a bitch. What a pussy baby back bitch. That's a huge bitch. Yeah, well, at least his afro looks nice. That's probably where he spends all of his attention.
Yeah, I mean, that is so ridiculous. I understand that you want to stand up for black people's rights and shit like that, but come on.
I know. And that's the thing. Like, I wonder if he sitting ever uses that a lot.
Yeah, sitting down for the national anthem. Yeah, you're really making a hell of a difference.
Like, I wonder if he's going to get his hair cut and he's just like pissed about something. He's like, I won't stand for it. Like, if I was the bride, I'd be like, he said it. Oh man,
I just like that sound effect.
Yeah, I'm surprised you got to use the Halloween one today. I didn't think you'd ever use that again. That's great.
All right, your turn. What do you got?
Okay, so instead of, you know, just looking through the news and finding what, you know, what man beat his wife today or whatever like that, I thought we'd do something a little different. And there's a lot of things on the internet where you can go to certain places. Reddit has a bunch of them. And you can look at people's just random ideas.
Okay.
Random ideas of random things, you know. For
like some, inventions or?
Not really, sort of. Like, some one guy talks about a really good movie that I actually would see. I'm surprised it's not a movie already. It might be, but I don't know. And they just come up. Oops, they just come up with ideas. And I have like 10 of them here, or something like that. We might do this again if, you know, I find more worth it. But and a lot of them have to do with Mount Everest for some reason. But I only picked one of those.
Why Mount Everest?
I have no idea.
It's gotten to the point now where like there's a rope you hold onto and shit. It's basically like standing in a line at the bank.
Mm-hmm. I know exactly. And the first one here is, make it a law that everyone who attempts to climb Mount Everest must wear chainmail. Then if climbers collapse and die, their bodies can be recovered by a helicopter swinging a giant magnet.
I know, dude. That's fucking brilliant.
Why aren't we funding this? Why are we not funding this?
By the way, a quick aside, if you keep hearing buzzing, I apologize. Our friend Matt is, like, texting the shit out of me.
Oh, really?
Is he okay?
Dude, Matt straight up sucks.
He has no idea we're recording right now, I assume, but he's texting the living shit out of me, and we have a rule that whoever's phone goes off during the show has to buy the beer next week, so I guess it's my turn.
Mm-hmm.
Well, really, yeah. It was anyway, but still.
Is he calling you?
I don't know who the hell that is.
Oh, you're like, that's someone. So the next one we got here is louder text tones when the message contains an exclamation point.
That'd be all right, except for we all know that one person who does everything in caps.
I know, just to be a fucking dick. But I actually, that sounds goofy when you first read it, but if you're like trying to talk to someone and you hear your phone like go off loud, you're like, okay, that was important, or someone's mad. The next one here, create a sports team called the Chameleons who wear the same exact jerseys as the team they're playing.
That's brilliant, man.
I know. I think that's fucking crazy. Some of these are pretty funny.
Hell, I like you. You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
Oh, man.
I'm pretty sure that there's regulations against that sort of shit.
Yeah, I know. But that's just funny. I had to put that one in there. And this one, okay, this guy recommends a movie, and I want to see this. Someone make this happen. A vampires versus werewolves movie in which vampires try to blow up the moon to stop werewolves from existing.
I would just like to see a werewolf versus vampire movie where nobody twinkles and it's not fucking gay.
Oh, jeez, don't even get me started on that.
Actually, Underworld was pretty badass.
Yeah, I know. Kate Beckinsale, leather. Oh, my God, don't even get me started. And what makes her even hotter is that she's British. And I don't know what accents do to me, but they make me rock hard. They give me a rager. Yeah, whoever...
I just like that sound effect. Yeah, it wasn't relevant.
Yeah, someone make that a fucking movie. That is awesome.
Like, that it would is be, pretty good.
Yeah, that's great.
Hey, they did it in Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah, that's true.
Nobody ever addresses the fact that it would have completely ruined tides and our entire environment. But hey, why not?
They're like, hey, I got rid of werewolves, whatever.
Hey, fuck it.
Okay, now this guy, he's probably just pissed. He probably works third shift and he's sick of this shit. Someone should put electric motors on street sweepers. You know he's probably sleeping. It's like, those goddamn street sweepers.
That was a good idea.
Nah, I don't know if it'll work. They're pretty big, dude. Do you think an electric motor could power one of those fucking things?
I don't know.
And I don't live in the city anymore, so I haven't even seen a street sweeper in how long.
Yeah, if you want the street swept, you better grab a fucking broom.
Yeah, I know. And people clean the streets off out here anyways because all the roadkill. Like, I'm going to eat tonight. This is pretty funny. This is just like a little contest someone came up with. Have a huge keg party with a $50 entry fee. At a set time in the evening, everyone must stop drinking and be breathalyzed. Whoever blows the highest wins all the money. Could you imagine a room full of people trying to get as drunk as possible?
We already have that, Casey. It's called college.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, and then, you know, what else would probably turn into this is, hey, I bet you I can stick a whole thing of butter down my throat.
Did you ever hear Edward Foti Hands?
No. Oh, yes.
Yeah, you do. Yeah. For those who are unfamiliar, Edward Foti Hands is you take Foties of Old English generally, and you,
Odie.
And you fucking duct tape two bottles to your hands so you cannot get your hands free until you have consumed both bottles of malt liquor.
Yeah, try having to pee really bad with two 40s duct taped to your hands.
Well, I actually heard a story once of some jackass. They were smoking cigars and somebody knocked one over and lit their apartment on fire and they all died because nobody could get out.
Oh my God, they're like, I can't open the door!
So the moral of the story is if you are going to play Edward Foti Hands, make sure you have somebody there who's at least halfway sober and has their free hands.
You need like a referee or something. There's also one, it's called Beer Staff. You have to drink with cans. And every time you finish a beer, you take your new one and you put it on top and you duct tape it to the older one. So by the end of the night, everyone's walking around with these huge beer staffs. And you have to have like people help you drink it at the end. That one's pretty fun.
Oh, so you have to drink it off the top of the staff?
Yeah, because the bottom one's empty and it's duct taped. And it's really funny, dude. I've had some good times playing that game.
I've never done that one.
Oh, that's great.
What happens when it's too high for the ceiling? Do you have to like kind of like make it into an arc?
Oh, no, you drink outside. You climb trees. Dude, I'm not even joking. I've seen people just sit in a tree because they get so pissed they can't drink anymore and they're getting sick of people asking them to help. So they just climb a tree and like have the thing there and try to... Oh, man, it's great.
And people say we're alcoholics.
Yeah, I know. Jesus. I got like four more here. This one. Bathe chickens in seawater before slaughtering them so you don't have to brine them later.
See, would that work?
I know. Like, would that work? And why did you think of that? Like, were you just in bed and you're like, God, did I leave the oven? No, I turned the oven off. You know, I got bills. I wonder if you made chickens in seawater. Oh, man. Like, who thinks of this shit?
That guy.
Yeah. He's
that
like,
guy thinks
must,
of it.
He must really like chicken.
He's going to be a millionaire.
Yeah.
Money.
And there was one after I didn't have on there, but someone was saying they should season KFC's fries with the seasoning that they fry their chicken in.
You know what? I might be wrong on this because I heard it from a not necessarily reputable source.
Mm-hmm.
But somebody once told me that their whole 12 herbs and spices, whatever the hell it is, it's salt and fucking pepper.
Oh, really? Yeah, I also heard that it's very simple because some guy was pissed that KFC fired him. And he just put the recipe out on the internet. And it was stupid. It was like salt and pepper and like one other thing.
Like paprika.
Yeah. So I got three more here. Oh, God, this beer. Have a blind person translate people's pimples if they were Braille. I know, but that's the thing. Like, what if your face actually says something? Like, he's touching. He's like, you're going to die today. I'm like, whoa.
Yeah, so instead of having, like, palm readers, we have pimple face readers.
Next one here. Save mass for women. Save massive amounts of money by living only off your own breast milk. I've read this, and I've guaranteed someone's tried this before. They're like, I took the light bulb out of the refrigerator, you know, everything to try to save money. Fuck it, I'm drinking my own breast milk. And last one here. This is cool, because this would open up so many possibilities. Bring your porn to work day. Everyone brings a flash drive, and they all go in a big basket, and everyone gets one.
Hey, all right. But is it amateur porn? Like, is it you and the hubby filming on a Saturday night?
No, like, it would probably be everything that you like. So, like, you know, pregnant porn or whatever you're into.
Beautiful human submarines.
Yeah, exactly. And imagine it. Like, being at work, though, because you know some sick motherfucker has some sick shit.
Oh, yeah, somebody's going to come up with the amputee midget tranny.
Yeah, so everyone's sitting at work the next day, and you're like, who is it? Who is it? Who's the freak in here?
Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah, so I thought that was pretty interesting, and there is so much of this. There's a lot of it on Reddit and everything like that. When you're bored, just read some of this shit. They are some good ideas, and like I said, there's, like, a lot about Mount Everest for some reason. I have no clue why.
Oh, man. Well, it's not quite breast milk, but speaking of consuming bodily fluids,
oh, great.
That leads us into my next story for us. So this chick named Tracy Kiss, you know, last week we said about, whatever, I'm just going to say it. This lady gets semen out of her friend and consumes it for health benefits.
Oh, great. Nice.
Yeah, so it's not quite the...
this one's for all the kids out there.
It's not quite the cocktails that we discussed last week, but this chick who might I add is not terrible to look at here.
I'd do her.
She might have something going on. She's a British chick, so.
Oh God, you had to tell me that. My pants just got tighter.
She's a single mom, and she enlisted the help of her best friend to supply her with his sperm in order to boost her immunity and stave off the common cold, as well as using it to. Like a facial.
Oh, great. Literally. oh, great. She's playing with it. That's
yeah,
nice.
She plays with it. I even have some video, so let's go ahead and listen to
her
this.
Her skin does look clear.
Her skin does look clear. I'll give her that. All right. Let me pull up the video here.
She looks excited, too.
Well, wouldn't you? You're about to get sperm all over your face. Okay. I managed to click off of it somehow because... Screw the internet.
Yeah, fucking technology.
All right, here we go. She's rubbing in the baby gravy.
Oh man.
It's face coated. It actually dries quite quickly. It's quite surprising.
It dries quickly. Are you surprised by that?
The skin.
When she starts bottling the stuff, that would be the tagline.
Soothing on the skin. I kind of put it in comparison with, you know, when you have chewing gum and you breathe in with chewing gum in your mouth, it's a cold, cool, refreshing feeling.
Yes,
and
so apparently really your semen is mint flavored.
Just absorb,
oh, great.
Feel it coming into your face. Pardon the pun.
Coming into your face.
I don't know if you can tell properly from this angle, but
her skin does look a little clear.
Sucks into the skin. It's absolutely beautiful. I don't mind the smell of semen. I think that it's something that is quite a natural smell, and I have no aversion to it.
Yeah, she doesn't mind the smell.
I think some people might find it a little bit of an acquired taste. So in that sense, I always find having incense sticks or something honestly.
Oh my god.
She recommends burning incense so you don't smell the smell the spunk.
If you find somebody that is ridiculous. Very healthy in their diet, it won't have the same tang to it and smell.
It won't have the same tang to it.
Tang, now I want some tang.
You want tang after hearing that?
Oh my god, I love the incense. That was great.
Probably smells like a man's bathhouse.
Oh, Jesus, man. First, the girl that swallows butter and this girl got to get together. Like, they need to do a podcast together because I would fucking watch that every day.
What you mean is they need to do a porno, not yes. a podcast.
Yeah, she's cute, man. I'd try to throw it in her, you know.
But the funniest part is somewhere down the line, somewhere on this article, it says that her friend was originally concerned that she was going to try to impregnate herself
with a turkey baster.
Yeah. That's so he had an initial aversion to providing the material.
Oh my god, that's funny. And that actually happens. We have a friend actually that does a lot of court cases dealing with children, and she has had some cases where a woman
poked holes in condoms and shit.
Yeah, just like turkey. There was a turkey baster one. It's just too much for me.
We probably shouldn't talk too much more about that. Yeah, we're going to get in trouble.
Yeah, where's the sex robots at?
Yeah, the sex robots are coming. I saw another. Ha ha! They're coming.
Uh oh.
They. I saw another article today, but I didn't want to talk about sex robots 3 weeks in a row.
I know. I had friends actually sending me stuff. They're like, "Hey, you should cover this on the show. You should." I'm like, "We actually already did," because I guess some lady actually tried it for the first time and she reviews it.
Awesome.
Yes.
No, hey, though, if any out there want us to talk about some shit, please send us the information. Yes. We're down with that.
Yes.
All right, before we move on to the next thing here, I think we can play our game next. What do you think?
Sure.
But first, I want to take a second to talk about a couple of things. First off, Patreon. If you're unaware, we've been talking about Patreon. It's a way to kick us a little bit of cash to keep this going. We love you. If you do, you can pledge as little as a dollar. That gets you access to our special feed. This week we're going to be putting up a special behind-the-scenes video for all of our patrons, who right now is limited to Shane Hartle. Thanks, Shane.
Yep.
Hey. So he'll get to watch the video, and if you guys want to see that, you're going to have to subscribe and kick back a little bit of cash our way. That helps us pay for all this, so that's cool. And on another thing we wanted to talk about, I have a giveaway going on my website, Theaterverse, which hosts the podcast, theaterverse.com. You can go there and enter the contest. It's for an HD home run. Let me go ahead and show you what this thing is. It's an HD home run prime. And what this is, it's a little device that connects to your network, and you get a cable card from your cable company. And here, let me go ahead and pull that up and you can take a look and look at it. This is the device right here.
It looks sleek.
Yes. This device right here, I have one. I love it. You have to have cable, though. It won't work if you use, if you use, like, satellite or anything like that, it's not going to work. But you got to get a cable card, plug it into that little M card only slot you see there.
Mm-hmm.
And what it does is it enables you to access all of your programming, and it'll broadcast it out over your network, and you can watch it on your computer. You can watch it on your tablet. Like, for example, if my kids want to watch their cartoons and I want to watch my own cartoons, I can pull up the HD Home Run app on their tablets. They can go and watch their Cartoon Network or whatever while I watch my cartoons. You know, I'll be rocking some Scooby-Doo. They'd be rocking some Amazing World of Gumball. So that's great. You avoid having to pay for a cable box, which is cool. If you have Comcast, they give you a cable card for free. So, hey, I got one cable box, and I've got one HD home run, and that feeds the rest of the TVs.
Hmm.
So go to theaterverse.com, and you will see the link to enter the giveaway. There's lots of ways you can enter. Visit our Facebook page, share another tweet.
Mm-hmm.
So go there and make sure you're a subscriber of this channel, and you'll get another free entry.
Yes, give us some love.
Give us some love.
Give us some love.
All right, so now that that's out of the way, we are going to play Would You Rather.
Oh, jeez. Would you rather swallow a stick of butter or put semen on your face?
All right, we're going to do this game called Would You Rather. I'm going to get them from rrrather.com for now, but if we do this in the future, you know, you could always send us options and we'll do a poll and see who what you would rather. And well, the way this is going to work is we are going to put in our answers and we're going to check and see what the hive mind had to say. And if our answers are different than the hive mind, then we are going to have to drink something special.
Oh, God. I'm not looking forward to this.
We have...
God help me.
Malta Goya. I've had this once before, and it tastes like liquid bran flakes.
Oh, jeez. It doesn't... Every time I see this stuff in the grocery store, I just think of, like, it's something you scream when you're about to do a karate move. Like, Goya! Goya!
They are a... I have no idea where the hell they're from. There's some sort of... I think they're Latin American or something, like Cuban, maybe.
Yeah, somewhere in maybe Central America or something, I think, isn't it?
It's either that or maybe Mexican. Either way, this brand has all sorts of ethnic foods. And this stuff is apparently popular in certain places. I've had this once before, and it tastes horrid.
Oh, God.
So, if we do not answer correctly, we get to take a shot of the Malta Goya.
Goya, coffee, and Satan beer. It's going to be an interesting bowel movement later.
This is going to be a day. So, we're going to go ahead. We're going to play Would You Rather.
Oh, Jesus.
Got our shot glasses here. We'll both come up with an answer, and whichever one of us doesn't agree with the vast majority of folks is going to have to take some of the Goya.
Ugh.
So would you rather be, here, let me go ahead and pull this up. There you go. Would you rather be a girl with a penis or a boy with a vagina?
Ugh, man. I don't know, dude.
I'm going to go ahead and be a girl with a penis because then at least I can get dudes to buy me shots.
I know. That's what I was thinking. I was like, I could really fucking take advantage of some guys if I was a girl with a penis. So I'm going to go with a girl with a penis.
All right. So our answer is we're going to go girl with a penis. Oh, we agree. We agree. Yes. We're safe.
Woo! Thank God. What was the percentage on that?
Is 68% would rather be the girl with a penis.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Yeah, because you could get away with stuff, you know.
If nothing else, we could do some pornography. So
yeah,
that.
That's another thing. Yeah. Fuck yeah.
Oh, who the hell came up with this one? Jackass19007, you are a dirty boy.
Yeah.
Would you rather shove a piece of glass in your dick hole or shove a string of nails in your asshole and rip them out?
Oh, man, dude, I don't want to do this. Oh, man, I don't want to sit down right now.
I don't know what to go with.
Shove a piece of glass in your dick hole.
I feel like you could sew that back up.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the piece of glass in your dick hole because that... fuck, never mind. You're going to have to pull it out.
Oh, yeah. You're going to... But you know what? Shove a string of nails in your asshole and then rip them out.
Yeah, there's more nails than there is glass, so it's going to hurt more, I think.
Oh, you know what, though? If it's a string of nails, it would be floppy. So all the nails would point back as you pulled it out. Ha-ha! Loophole.
Oh, I don't know about that. Maybe one or two, but not all of them.
Well, come on. If they're all pointing out this way, and it's a rope, you know, when you pull it out, they'd all fold back in.
That's true. But I don't think anyone got that deep into it.
Got that deep into it.
Oh, man, that's a tough one, dude. I don't know, man. I'm going to have nightmares about this.
You got to pick one.
I have the glass, the broken glass one. I'm doing the broken glass.
Yeah, I feel like you could sew that back up. Yeah.
And
yeah.
I just...
Oh, we were wrong.
Oh, no.
We were wrong.
We should have went with the nail. You had me convinced there, though, with the nail thing. Like,
we,
I was like...
We should have gone for the nail thing. It was 42% glass, 58% nails.
Oh, God.
All right. Here's our first deal.
Oh, Jesus.
We're just going to do a little bit because I only have one bottle of this. Ugh. Oh, God. It just...
It's like the color of the beer.
Oh, my God.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Ugh. Oh my God, dude!
It's so bad.
Oh, dude. Oh, dude.
If it tastes like food,
dude, you're right. That tastes like pureed Raisin Bran.
It doesn't taste like a drink. It tastes like it should be chewed.
I know. I feel like I need a fork and knife to drink that.
My coffee?
Jesus Christ. Oh, man.
I don't like this game anymore.
Yeah, that was probably worse than the broken glass in the dick hole. Oh, my God. Dude, the taste isn't going away.
Oh, it's not. Even with a coffee, it's not.
Oh, man. That's fucking disgusting.
Oh, let's hope
we
don't.
You sick fuck. I hate you.
Let's hope we don't fuck up again. Oh, it's so bad.
I need a... Okay.
Okay.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, man. If you guys are listening to this, you might want to go to YouTube. Yeah. I'd imagine our faces are pretty good here.
Oh, man. It's the...
Oh. Okay. Steal myself here.
Oh, man.
Would you rather smell like a fart for the rest of your life or drink a diarrhea milkshake?
Diarrhea milkshake? Like, why would you want to smell a fart for the rest of your life?
You smell like the fart, so it's not really you that's going to be affected. It's everybody around you.
Wait, you smell like a fart? No, it says you do.
It says you would smell like a fart for the rest of your life. Not you smell the fart, but you smell like
Oh, yeah, and that's what I'm saying. You imagine trying to get laid, unless it's like one of the girls from Two Girls, One Cup.
So you're about diary milkshakes, huh?
I don't know. This is another tough one, because you know what? I see a lot of pity sex. So if you smell like farts and you couldn't get laid, you could just post on the internet your like sad story, but like, man, I'm a virgin. No one will sleep with me because I smell like shit.
You know what? I'm going to go with smell like a fart for the rest of my life. Because you know what? I'm already married. I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
I don't need sex that bad.
I'm going to go with smell like fart for the rest of your life.
All right. We're going for it. Oh, no.
Who in the fuck would have...
You people are weird.
I know, dude.
45% said smell like a fart. 55% said drink a diarrhea milkshake.
Oh, man. I don't want to. I don't want to.
No, Daddy, no.
Don't put the straw in my mouth. Oh, man. This is horrible. Coffee, beer, and Goya. Goya!
Who would drink this?
I don't know.
You know what? A quick little story before I take our next shot. In Pennsylvania, there's no tax on food. And I had $2 in my pocket, and I went to buy two bottles of this shit, so we both have our own. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of glad I didn't.
Oh, man.
At this point. But when I went to ring it in, this shit had tax on it, which means, according to the state of Pennsylvania, this isn't food.
Oh, really? Ugh.
Down the hatch, motherfucker.
Cheers, motherfucker.
Ugh.
Oh, dude, two scoops of raisins my ass.
Oh, that's so bad.
Oh, who in the fuck buys this shit? Oh my God. What do you
mean? It had dust on it on the shelf.
Oh, God. It tastes like dust. Oh, my God.
My eyes are watering.
Oh, my God. I've never had my tongue punch me in the roof of the mouth before. Like, my mouth is pissed at me. He's like, fuck you.
Quit making me laugh. Every inhale I get is...
Oh, man. This poop later. Is going to be satanic.
Oh, my God. This is horrible.
Oh, man. Go ahead, man. Keep going.
Do we have to?
Yeah. Let's just get it done.
Would you rather have constipation or explosive diarrhea?
These are hard. You can die from constipation, though. When I was younger, I swallowed a piece of gum and I didn't shit for like a month. I got really sick.
Both of these could kill you, so that's kind of irrelevant in the conversation.
Yeah. And that's... Oh, God. I saw the next one.
Yeah.
I saw the next one and I'm like, I know what road that's taking us down.
All right, well, let's get this one over with. I'm just going to go for fucking... You're both going to die. You're going to die either way, so I'm just going to go for constipation. At least I don't leave a mess.
Yeah, exactly, and it's not annoying. Like, you can just sit there and smoke cigarettes until you die and drink. I'm going to go with constipation.
All right. Thank the Lord, there is a God! Woo-hoo-hoo. 55% said constipation, 45% said explosive diarrhea.
We're good at something. Ugh. Oh, God, this one.
Would you rather eat out blue waffle or get it in the rear? If you have never seen a picture of a blue waffle, you're not going to want to Google that. But if you do, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's basically, I don't know if it's a disease or like, you know.
It's just a fucking disgusting fungus growing on vagina.
Yeah, it has to do with a panty hamster, but, you know, it's just, I don't know. I don't know what it is. And that's the best way to put it.
Dude,
it
I'm taking an ass pounding.
I know, I'm taking it. I'm in the butt. In the
there's not even a question.
Yeah, put it.
Lube it up. Lube it up. Give me something to drink.
Yeah, put it in my fucking ass.
Give me a pillow to bite. There's not even a question.
Oh, man.
Woo! Oh, all right, we're safe.
That's a big percentage, too, isn't it? What's the percentage on it?
It's 63% to 37%. Yeah. The internet agrees with us.
Yeah, and whoever fucking voted for that, you sick fuck, go fuck yourself.
This one's sort of silly, and I have a story to go with this, too.
Oh, great.
Well, would you rather have sandpaper hands or no genitals?
If you have sandpaper hands, you're going to have no genitals from masturbating.
Yeah, exactly. It's a damned if you do and a damned if you don't situation. But here, before we go through this, my quick little story is I have been considering getting a vasectomy. I've got two kids. You know, I'm done. I've had enough. I'm done.
Better to unload the gun than shoot at a bulletproof vest.
Right, exactly. And my wife's getting to the point where, you know, birth control is not good for her. It does not affect her well. Mm-hmm. So she's about sick of it. And rubbers suck.
Yes, they do.
So I'm just going to go... I'm thinking about the vasectomy route, but knowing my fucking dumb luck, my dumb ass would end up with a fucking infection and look like a Ken doll afterwards. I was telling this to my mom the other day. I work with my mom, you know. Aren't I all grown up and shit? I work with my mom. Anyway, I work with her, and I was talking to her the other day. I had her laughing her ass off, because I'm like, knowing my luck, I would fucking get an infection. I'd end up having to have the whole fucking twig and barriers removed. End up looking like a Ken doll.
Does that happen a lot? Men get infection?
I don't know. I didn't exactly go look. If I'm going to do this, I don't want to scare myself with checking out statistics.
If you do it, I'd just say get it done. Yeah, don't look it up. Don't scare yourself. Yeah.
I mean, it's so much easier for me to just go get a little snip done than for my wife to continue to like have chemicals pumped into herself.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, this is Trump's America.
Yeah, Trump's America.
So they're talking about maybe getting rid of having insurance companies have to pay for birth control. So you know, whatever I decide to do. But anyway, all right. So have sandpaper hands or no genitals.
I say sandpaper hands because at least you can put gloves on. No genitals, man. That's just fucking weird. Actually, you know, oh man, I don't know.
How do you pee?
Does the testosterone and wanting to have sex go away?
I don't know.
If that's the thing, fuck yeah. you'd never have a woman take advantage of it.
You'd be growing man tits though. You need that testosterone.
Who cares? Because you want sex, you wouldn't care. She'd be like, you're ugly. I'd be like, so? I'm not trying to fuck you. I can't.
All right, I'm going sandpaper hands. What are you going with?
Sandpaper hands.
All right, sandpaper hands it is. Woo! Oh, okay. 77% to 23. You know, we have to keep going until this bottle is gone, right?
No. No. No, we don't. No, we don't. Because there's a lot of that bottle left.
We're going to have to start taking bigger shots when we fail.
Yeah.
All right, would you rather cut your eyelids off with scissors or pull your teeth out one by one with a wrench? Oh, my God.
Jeez, I don't know, dude.
Jaeger, you're a mean dude.
Ah, man, that's a tough one.
I think I'm going to go with eyelids just because it'll be fast. One done.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know. But with pulling your teeth out, you could, like, throw some fucking alcohol in your mouth and swish it around to make the pain away. But
I think that would exacerbate
things. Can you live without eyelids?
I don't know.
That's what I'm trying to think. Can you live with...
I mean, you have to walk around... You bring up a good point there. You'd live, but you'd have to walk around constantly with, like, Visine.
Yeah, or, like, goggles or something.
You'd have to moisten your eyes constantly. With no teeth, you can at least get dentures.
Nah, I'd say teeth. It'd be painful, and you're right, it would be longer, but I don't think you can live... You probably can...
Yeah, but you know what? Once the teeth is done, it would be agonizing and horrible. You're right, though. You wouldn't have the eyelid. Like, the eyelid, you'd have to constantly put Visine in your eyes for the rest of your life.
Yeah, that'd be annoying.
You wouldn't even be able to sleep.
That'd be like the explosive diarrhea thing. Like, it'd just be inconvenient.
How would you be able to sleep? Yeah, okay, all right. I concur. Teeth.
Yeah, teeth. Definitely teeth.
You've made the argument successfully. 54%. All right, we're doing all right.
God, we're good at this.
We're getting better.
Well, we got two wrong so far, I think.
Yep. Yeah, if you were flexible enough to pleasure yourself orally, would you? Yes.
Fuck yeah.
Is there even a question?
Well, this is Trump's America. Of course I would.
Who would say no?
I know.
Fucking yeah. That's not even a question.
Jesus Christ. Put that dick in my mouth.
Would you rather eat worm spaghetti or cricket soup? cricket soup for me. I like the crunch. Go with the crunch.
I'm going. Hold on a second. Let me think this through. I'm thinking the worm spaghetti because spaghetti already feels like you're eating worms, so I don't think it would make that big of a difference. I really don't.
I'm pretty sure there's going to be a taste difference there.
Soup is already actually sort of disgusting to me if you think about it. It's like vegetables bathtub water.
What's wrong with you?
How much time do you get?
All right, so you're going worm spaghetti?
Yes.
I'm going cricket soup.
This is the first time we're giving different answers. I'm interested to see what this is.
Cricket soup.
What the fuck is wrong with people? Soup? Ew.
It's not even the crickets you're offended by. It's the soup part.
Whatever.
Bottoms up, motherfucker.
You know what? I'm happy that we're taking the bigger shots after I lose.
We talked about it beforehand. Oh, it God. Wasn't planned.
Oh, Jesus, my body's not ready for this.
Get it over with. You didn't even start drinking yet.
Oh, my God. I don't like it. I don't like it.
I feel bad for you. I'm just looking at it and feeling bad for you.
I need my safe place.
Pizza party and puppies.
The taste isn't really that strong.
But it's not good.
But it doesn't... It's sort of weak, but the taste doesn't go away. It just stays in there.
Dude, this is like staining our fucking table. I know. We're going to have to scrub it.
It's like a homeless person that's just like in my mouth. Ugh. That's what this tastes like, homeless people. Never tasted one, but ugh.
Ugh. All right. All right, next one. Would you rather have sex with a walrus or never have sex again? I'm saying buckle up, walrus.
Yeah, the walrus, of course, dude. What the fuck is this? Yeah, like, Jesus.
That is closer than I thought it was going to be. It's 60-40.
Really? Who the fuck doesn't want to have sex?
I mean, lube up. Close your eyes. You can still pretend.
Yeah, I know, man. Like, who cares?
It's a fucking walrus. It's not like it's got fucking teeth in its vagina. I know,
and look how many fucking rolls they have to hold on to. That'd be a good time.
Ooh, this one's kind of a toughie.
Oh, yeah.
Which movie would you rather happen to you, despite the shitty grammar? Would you rather Final Destination or Saw?
Ooh, this is a tough one.
The only thing I'm going to say about this is if you go with Saw, and it specifies Saw, not Saw 2 or 3 or whatever, uh-huh. where Shawnee Smith's character basically gave people no way out, but the original Saw where there was a way out... At least you survive. With Final Destination, you're going to die. Eventually.
I know. That's what I would say. Final Destination, you're always looking behind your back and stuff like that. Saw, at least you have a fighting chance. I fucking hate Final Destination. When I'm behind a log truck, I think of that. You remember that in that movie?
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, no, thank you.
No, thank you.
No, and I fucking stop and pull over. I'm not even joking. And I wait for that motherfucker to get away from me. Yeah. I'm going with Saw.
All right, I'm...
You'd be too paranoid with Final Destination always looking over your back and
I
stuff.
Concur. Oh.
Who, what?
Oh.
No one else made that argument? Are you kidding me?
You people are weird.
Why?
73% to 27%.
Why would you not have...
Why would you want the guaranteed death?
I know, yeah, I don't understand that. Whatever, you fucking nuts.
Don't feel bad. I have to do this with you. My fucking hands are getting sticky from... Oh, I have more than you. Whatever.
You deserve it, you prick.
Cheers.
Dude, oh, I'm going to puke.
I can't swallow.
Dude, that was a burp puke. That was a puke burp. Ew! Don't do that!
Hey, oh, my God.
I need some mouthwash or something.
Why would somebody buy this stuff?
Dude, I would eat a butthole to get this taste out of my mouth. Seriously.
That might be one of the questions, so be prepared.
Oh, man. The taste lingers, man.
It's making my eyes water. I'm not even kidding you.
Well, we're about a half a bottle. Almost.
I don't want to play anymore.
Well, how about we do, what, two more, maybe three more? How many more do you want to do?
Let's just finish the page we're on.
Okay. Good idea. Good idea.
Yeah.
Oh, man, this stuff. Ugh. The coffee sort of helps, but not really.
It's almost like it complements the taste.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, definitely. Whew. Okay. What do we got next?
This is
Please
not
don't cool. make those sounds right now. My mouth's watering, like before you puke.
Oh, my eyes are watering and shit.
No. Nope.
All right. Would you rather sleep with your dad once a month or kill your mother? I'm saying bye, Mom. Sorry.
Yeah. Nope. Mom, I love you dearly. We've had a lot of good times, but you were getting the knife. You get the knife. Actually,
considering your dad's dead, he's a grocer.
Here's the thing.
But you have to fuck a corpse.
Yeah, I never knew my dad. So does that mean he wouldn't be around to fuck me? Is that an argument here?
I'm saying he's zombie style. You come up with a rotten
fuck
dick.
Bye. Yeah, fuck bye, Mom. I'm sorry, dude. I am sorry.
Sorry, Mom. You gotta go.
Yeah, nope.
Woo! All right, we're safe. Would you rather get head or give it? Well, that's fucking... I'm not even...
You're like, fuck that.
Get head. Of course it's get head. I'm actually curious to see what the answer is. Oh. No. What the hell? I don't want to log in. 77% said get it. Yeah, no shit. You know what? There's 23% of you out there. You are generous, folks.
There is women addicted to giving head. I'm not joking. I've met a couple and it is insane. Awesome. Like, if they could snort dick, they would.
All right, would you rather eat a little piece of crap or pop a zit on someone's bum with your mouth?
Fucking pop a zit on someone's bum with your mouth! Like, what? Is that even... You're eating shit, man. It doesn't say anything about swallowing the zit or anything. You just have to pop it.
Yeah, but dude, if it's like a whitehead, it's gonna like...
I don't care. It's still not shit. Like the stuff we're drinking.
All right, fair enough. Yeah.
Hey, you do whatever you want. You do whatever you want.
We'll go pop a zit. Oh, we're safe. Ugh. Would you rather drink 2 liters of sweat or eat 3 big cups of toe cheese? I'll go with the sweat, man. It's just salty water.
Yeah, sweat. Toes, feet, fuck feet. I hate feet.
Yeah, feet are gross. All right, we're good.
Yeah, other people agree. Thank fucking God. Who are these sluts?
Would you rather eat out your sister or intercourse with your cousin? Well, I don't have a sister, so this is going to be a problem.
But what if you did? We gotta Photoshop you in a wig.
I'd go with a cousin because, you know, we live in a rural area. That shit's okay here.
Yeah, that's true, actually. Oh, man, I don't know. You see your cousin a lot less, so I'd say your cousin.
Yeah. Like, you see it makes family reunions awkward.
And I like how the pictures here are like two slutty girls. Like, that's your sister and your cousin, you fucking sick bastards.
All right, so we're doing cousin.
Yeah.
Wow, that's Ooh. Not even close.
Yeah, that's a huge thing. I think that's the same thing. Like, you see your sister all the time. Oh, why is there blood on the toilet? Oh, this is great.
Would you rather piss broken glass or crap razor blades?
Words are hard. Piss glass, because at least you can aim it at people.
Either way, you're fucked. Eh?
Actually, no, we've learned from this. The other one about the glass in the dick hole in the butt one won. So do you think we should go the route of people think butt pain's less painful?
Hmm.
It is painful having a dick, dude.
Yes, it is.
Especially with things like, you know, it makes you get into the marriage and have kids.
Yeah, I like my wife and kids.
Yeah. Okay. I'm just joking. I'm a miserable piece of shit.
Yes, you are.
I don't know. That's
all right. Let's go with the ass.
Yeah, I'm going with the ass, too. It would be fun to shoot broken glass at people with your dick, but...
This is two sides of a bad situation.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look. Oh, good.
Yeah, we went with the, yeah. People on here, you know, think, I don't know.
Would you rather have sex with your best same-sex friend once?
Let's move along.
Or only your sex toys and be forever alone?
Only your sex toys and be forever alone? I ain't fucking you, Jay.
I'm sad.
I'm in the baby face. I like baby face.
You don't like that?
No, I ain't into the grizzly.
All right, so sex toys it is. I agree. Oh no!
God, you guys are like
64% to 30. It's not even a contest.
You guys must be really good friends out there, man. Actually, you know what? Probably a lot of them are like, yeah, we fucked before. It was one night. It was our first time drinking vodka. Oh, man. You fucking sick fucks. I hate how the shots are getting bigger every time.
I'm trying to end this.
Oh, man. Every time I hear that
look
stuff.
Look at the color. Here, let me show this to the camera. Look at the color of this shit. This is not something you should be drinking. This is not Coca-Cola. Look at the color of the head.
Is it considered soda?
It is.
Malt beverage.
It's malt beverage. It's basically
oh my God, I got it on my hands.
It's basically unfermented beer. All right, let's do this.
My mouth waters every time you pour a shot of this.
Oh, my God. I'd imagine getting raped by your father would be less less bad.
We need paper towels to wipe my tongue off with.
I'm all right.
Don't scare me there.
I'm all right.
You are cleaning that up. You are cleaning that up, man. We'll get that fucking bitch from Family Guy in here with 11 pledge to clean that up, because I am not doing it. I am not doing it. Not today. What do we say to death? Not today. Game of Thrones fans
out
there.
It's like stuck in my mustache and shit.
Oh, man. Your wife's going to kiss you later, and she'll be like, why do you taste like Raisin Bran? It's always a good morning with two scoops of raisins, Peter. You remember that episode, Family Guy? Okay. Oh, man, this stuff makes you warm.
I'm pretty sure that's the growing nausea that's doing that.
Oh, man. Oh. Yeah, because I'm fine, like, until you pour it, and then I get, like, sick to my stomach, because I know the devastation and sadness that's about to happen to my body.
Why do people like this? Why is this a product?
I don't know.
Who's in charge of ordering this stuff to put it on the shelves?
I think they should make it into a karate movie called Goya. That's the only use for this. This is all we can get out of this.
This shit's against the Geneva Convention. Yeah. I swear to God. Fuck waterboarding. This shit's worse.
Oh, man.
Okay. All right. This is going to be a tough one, too, so I have a feeling we're going to be finishing this bottle. Would you rather cut off your penis and have an unlimited money, or be homeless and get laid all the time?
Ooh.
Oh, God. It's worse the second time.
I know. I'm trying to think straight, but, you know, I'm getting raped by the Raisin Bran sun in my brain. Like,
it's so
he's
gross.
He's raping me.
It's so gross.
Oh, man. All right. And let me focus here. Cut off your penis and have unlimited money. Be homeless and get laid for the rest of your life.
Ugh. Yo, I'm going for the money. I'm going for the money.
Yeah.
You could just, like, finger my little pee hole or whatever you got.
Yeah, that's... man, I don't know. This is a tough one.
You can disagree with me.
I'm going with being homeless and getting laid for the rest of your life.
All right, I'm going penis and having unlimited money. One of us is going...
No, unlimited money. I'm going unlimited money.
All right, yep, unlimited money. Unlimited.
Yeah.
You could probably, like, get fucking little... Is that
And that picture, is that what they think homeless people look like?
I guess so. Creeper. I mean, they could give us, like, neural enhancement things that plug into your brain and give you the sex feeling. I'll go with unlimited money.
Yeah, like Demolition Man.
Damn it.
Why did I listen
damn
to
it,
you?
Damn it,
why
son
did
of
I
a
listen
bitch.
To you, you sick fuck?
What the hell? Why is it my fault?
It is your fault. See, there it goes again. I see you pouring it, and I get sick.
Just, we're going to do it and be done. Ugh. Okay, well, here you go.
Hold on, I need a sec.
You need to steady yourself.
Well, just like when you pour it, I get sick and then my mouth waters. And it's just, oh.
This is the last one.
Okay. I fucking hate you.
Gah!
Dude, I know why they call it Goya, because when you drink it, you want to go... Oh, my God. Dude, if I get sick later, I am kicking your ass.
Oh, dude, I can't even...
I got other stuff to do today.
Not anymore, you don't.
I want to go grocery shopping, and, like, I'm going to shit myself in the middle of the aisle. They'd be like, Goya on aisle 7?
Well, that was the end of our game.
Oh, man.
Technically,
we're never doing that again.
Technically, I won because you had to drink once more than me, but...
Yeah, you fucking dick.
I don't feel good about it.
No, I don't either. That was fucking horrible. Whoever makes this, go fuck yourself. I hope you die in a car accident.
Goya, you got the best of us.
Oh, man, it's just horrible. I wonder what my shit's going to smell like later. That's what I'm thinking. Like, you know when you eat McDonald's and you shit in your food? It smells like McDonald's. Like, what is this going to do to our poop? And especially this dark shit, our poop's going to be, like, black, midnight black.
If you sadistic bastards want to see us do this again, leave a comment.
Yeah. Or don't, because I don't want to do this again, Jay, you fucking asshole. But hey, look at the bright side. We can get 10 cents for the bottle. I got my hands again.
It's sticky. It's gross.
Oh, man. Whatever. I just got it and puke. I'll probably puke later.
Whatever. Subscribe. Fucking.
Yeah. That's after that. That's pretty much it for our show.
Yeah. Fucking subscribe. Like us. Fucking whatever. Yeah. See you later. See you next week.
Have a good one.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
In case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.